Hey guys, welcome back to a new video on The First Descendant. Today I wanted to cover the basics for weapon modding, what you need to look at, what should you do with your weaponry adjustments, so what stats should you roll for, and then naturally what modules should you put on your weapon. And then in the last part I want to go over some special modules that might not be good on certain weapons but excel on other weapons. And with this said, everything is timestamped down below. But then again, if you're expecting this to be a video where I'm like, oh my god, if you do this you get 3 billion damage out of your gun, that's not the case. This should be more of like a baseline so that everybody knows how to at least get somewhat decent damage out of your weapons. As for me currently, I'm sitting between like 30 to 40 million damage when I'm doing a boss fight, and I know it's mostly weapon damage because none of my characters is built to deal damage to Colossi's, and in certain cases I even go up to like 50 million damage, so it's not the best, but I'm quite confident that I know what I'm doing. So with this, let's start with the first part, and this is the baseline stats of your weapon. If you hover over a gun and you press F1 on PC, this might be different on console, you have a ton of basic stats. Now those are a bit skewed since there's some stuff on the guns, so what I will be doing is we will go into our access info menu and then we take a look at the Thunder Cage, for example, since it's the first gun you basically get. And here we have some basic stats. The stats you want to look at are firearm critical hit rate, firearm critical hit damage, and weak point damage. With the Thunder Cage we can see we have a very high crit chance and good crit damage, while our weak point damage is very low, it's only 1.2. So this tells us that with this gun it makes a lot of sense to spec into firearm critical hit rate and firearm crit hit damage, since those stats are naturally good and since everything we will mod to the gun will go based off our basic stats. So let's say we get a module that gives us 50% crit hit rate. This doesn't mean we suddenly go to 70%, it just means we get 50% crit rate hit rate from our baseline. Our baseline is 20%. So 50% from 20% is 10%, so this takes our new firearm critical hit rate up to 30%. This is also why those base stats are very important, because if we take a look at my rocket launcher I have for my Glay build, we only get a firearm critical hit rate of 1% as base. This means even if we somehow get like 100% extra critical hit rate with our modules, we would only go up to a 2% crit hit rate, what is completely useless. Those are the baselines. Let's go into our weapon modding, and for this, first of all, I wanted to show you real quick. We are modding the Python, so we look at the stats. We only have a 5% critical hit rate and 1.35 crit hit damage when we crit, so it's not really good to build crit hit rate on this, since the maximum we could get would be like a 10% chance or something, and 10%, that's 1 in every 10 bullets. That's not really something I think is really good, but we get a 2x weak point damage. So what I'm thinking now is I want base damage on this gun, and I definitely want weak point damage. Then since this gun is going to be my Colossi weapon, I want flat damage against Colossi on this thing, and then the fourth thing is up to whatever you prefer. But here in this case, since every gun has a unique ability, and the unique ability on the Python is that we actually reduce the toxin resistance on the enemy with every shot we hit on a weak point up to 20 stacks. This means it would make sense to also roll for poison damage on this gun, and so that's what we are trying to do now. Now here we are in the weapon readjustments. As you can see, I haven't rolled anything. Those are the basics one the gun came with. I have a few of them, and so again, what we want to roll is firearm, naturally gold. Then I want weak point damage. Then since it's my bossing gun, I want firearm attack against Colossi. And then lastly, we want toxic attack, since we reduce toxic resistance from the enemy if we hit weak points. So let's just roll it a few times and see what we get. Okay, toxic attack, nice, but it's not gold, and we got firearm critical hit rate on gold, very nice if this gun would actually crit. So now we rolled our first useful thing, toxic attack, 1222. We can see the maximum is 1226, so that's a nice roll. Now if you roll something that's very good, you can actually click on it and lock it. This will obviously increase our cost, but this means this won't reroll again, so let's continue. Okay, firearm crit hit rate, firearm critical hit damage, I think those are actually the most we can get. Yeah, almost, those are good, but we want neither of those, but we take firearm against Colossi. Now I think we can roll higher. I'm mainly speculating currently to get firearm attack gold, and then we will go from there. So now, after basically rolling all my readjustment materials away, we landed on toxic attack, weak point damage, firearm attack, and rounds per magazine. Firearm attack, I'm missing 0.4% damage, and rounds per magazine is not something we want, so I guess I have to farm them up again, and then I got a reroll, but now you have at least seen it in action a bit. Now let's move on to the modules. Now, as for the modules, I will talk about, or I will basically take a look at my Thunder Cage. I would argue this gun isn't perfectly built for either farming or for Colossi. The simple fact is that it's currently still my utility gun, so since I'm using it everywhere and I don't want to swap modules all the time, this is the best of both worlds. But yeah, a look at my stats that I'm currently having. I'm critting basically 1 in 3 bullets. When I crit, I do 4.436 times the damage, plus I get 1.62 weak point damage, and then I also have a slot for bullet improvements depending on the weakness of the enemy. But yeah, let's start with the modules first. So the most important module you will put on every gun, doesn't matter the class, will be action and reaction, for the simple fact that you get 60% firearm attack or only a 20% recoil increase. That's super cheap, since in this game no gun basically has any recoil. And then the next thing you will put on is rifling reinforcement with another 32% firearm attack. So those two you can basically throw on every gun without any problems. The next thing you want to put on would be better insight for crit hit rate, almost 40% if your gun crits. On the Thunder Cage, you have a very high base crit chance, so it makes sense. On the Python, I wouldn't use this. Now, if your gun does crit damage and crit chance, the next thing would also be better concentration for firearm critical damage. 75% increase, that's a lot. If your gun doesn't use this and your gun is a weak point damage gun, weak point sight. 35% weak point damage, very nice. So those were the super basics. Action and reaction and rifling reinforcement every gun. Then you need to take a look. Does your firearm have good critical hit rate and critical hit damage? Then you do better insight and better concentration. If it only does weak point, you do weak point sight for an increase. And after this, you can really do whatever you want. Since I'm critting with this gun, I try to get stuff that improves my crit rate and crit damage. For example, commando marksmanship, crit hit damage plus 34% and 1% firearm attack is really good. Then I used insight focus. This gives me more firearm critical hit rate and crit hit damage, so two of the stats I really want. Then I took reload insight for more crit hit rate and reload time modifier. On the Thunder Cage, I'm personally not a fan of using an extended mag since I don't really get a lot out of it, but I like to reload, and since this gives me reload and crit hit rate, I just threw it on. And then also fire rate concentration, more fire rate, more crit hit damage. That's basically what I've been using on this gun. And then lastly, an elemental type, depending on the weakness on the Colossi. Since if you look up the Colossi, it says it's weak against a certain element. I can't tell you exactly what weak means. Does it mean the Colossi takes 100% damage when it's this element? Does it mean the Colossi takes more damage, like 150%, or whatever it means? This is really good and you should have it basically on every gun. And also what I dislike a lot is that those modules all have different symbols, so you can't just put on one of your crystallization catalysts here to make it easier to have less of a cost, but at least with my build currently that isn't needed. Now let's get into some special modules. So if we go back into our access info, there are some modules that, or some ultimate modules that make sense on certain guns but are very useless on other guns. So the first thing we have would be something like toxic conductor. When you attack an enemy inflicted with poison, you deal more firearm attack damage, and as you can see, you can level it up quite a bit. This, for example, I would put on my gun, and I will probably put on my Python when I make my Frainer build, simply because with Frainer I'm poisoning the enemy constantly, so I'm getting free damage out of it. But this is something special. This, for example, wouldn't make sense on like a bunny. So the next thing that might be useful would be weak point expansion. On weak point hit, weak point damage plus 35. Of course, this scales up when you upgrade the module, but this is something that would make sense on a sniper rifle. Since with a sniper rifle, you're shooting only the weak point, and your whole deal with a sniper rifle is basically one shot a ton of damage. It would make sense that you do something, you put on something like this on your sniper rifle, since on SMG, for example, this wouldn't make any sense. Why would I want this on my SMG where I'm like spitting bullets the whole time? And then the last thing would be something like mental focus. You basically put it on LMG. I can get up to 150 stacks when I continuously fire. And here again, on SMG, this wouldn't make a lot of sense, since even with an extended magazine module, I would only get up to like 40 rounds, but on an LMG that comes with 100 rounds or 110 rounds, you could slap this on, and then of course it would make sense that you also put on an extended magazine. And that's basically it, that's the baseline. You know now what to look for in your gun, what stats to look for, you know how you should do your weapon readjustments, then you know what modules are good, and you also know what other modules you could put on depending on the situation. Again, if I were using Blair for example, I would put on this. For what I could think about would be using like this, since I'm mainly playing Bunny, I'm electrocuting the enemy, so this would be something I could just throw on my Thunder Cage and would probably get more damage. So I hope you now have a basic understanding on how to mod your weapons, and I also hope you enjoyed this video. I will see you in the next one.